Welcome back, guys. We are on the Mega Halo at the Rogi distribution point, looking down towards Troy. I tell you what, after you've had like a week off from playing a game and you come back, you're just like fresh and hungry and pumped. I've been having a look around at like a whole bunch of different things, and I'm like, I am so pumped. Okay, let me give you a quick example before we dive in and get started with a bunch of stuff that I want to do. For example, right, if you look at the distribution over here in Confusedford. Now, you remember when I redid Confusedford, I tried to knock down all the buildings and just have the residential around the outside. And then I wanted the commercial in here, and I wanted all the industrial over here. Now, some of the industrial is kind of filtered over there. Now, I could start knocking these buildings down, which I probably will do, in actual fact, to get it over here. But I'll show you for why, right? And the reason why is if you come down to this kind of level, right, you actually get a proper industrial zone with all industrial buildings, right? And then you come up towards here, and then you look across, and this is the residential, and you've got these kind of residential apartment blocks. And then you look over here, and this is the, you know, the commercial, I guess the commercial and financial center with all these, you know, big skyscrapers, all very affluent. I just think it's awesome. And I started looking at this area down here, and I was thinking, you know, I really need a road that comes like out here and goes down the side here, so we can have buildings like all in here, because this is like the center of the city. There shouldn't be like big wide open green spaces like right along the tracks. We want the buildings to come out a bit more and stuff like that. And it's all about giving these individual cities, you know, like real character and stuff. I really want to get on and do that. But what are we going to start off with? Well, we've got the basic Mega Halo in now. And the trains running on the Mega Halo are all working. What we want to do next is get all of the feeder lines into the distribution points for Sector 1 working again. Because, like, none of them are working at the moment. So, should we get on and do it? Let's get on and do it. And I'm going to try and keep this interesting. I'm going to try and do, like, little bits and pieces, and I'll kind of, like, show you examples of what I'm doing as I'm kind of going along, and we'll kind of bring it to life. So, for example, now, first change I'm going to make, I've changed the colour schemes. So, the Applejack, so food lines are going to be green. Oil, black, which they were anyway. Fuel will stay red. But stone, I've decided to make this light grey. And construction materials, this brown colour, for like bricks and stuff like that. I thought that kind of makes sense. And then, now these are, the Applejack line will stay as the Applejack line, because that's kind of a unique one. The same as the Spencer food line will stay as the Spencer food line over there. But this one is going to change. This is not going to be ice cream. We'll call them based on where they're feeding into. So this is going to be Confusedford. Confusedford. Which I think makes a hell of a lot more sense. And it'll make things easier to follow. Don't you think? Do you think? Good idea. Okay. Confusedford. Cha-ching. Right. Let's start getting these working then. So let's start off with this one. Now, what's the length of this platform? This is a 240. You know what? I'm going to increase these to 320s, because the platform over here for this station is a 320, and we're going to need, bear in mind, we're bringing in stuff to be distributed to two whole sectors. So that's feeding six or seven, or potentially eight big cities. That's a huge potential demand. And to even get close to filling that, I'm pretty sure all of our feeder lines are going to eventually have to be quad-tracked. But they're going to at least, I think, need 320 stations. So let's start doing that. Okay, so having done that, that train is fine, right? So that's going to go back out there. And then this train is, yeah, that train's going in the right direction. Hooray. Good news. I think actually changing those signals just flipped around that train, because it wasn't doing that before. I think it was coming in the opposite direction. Right, let's have a look at the stone line. So the stone line, I'm going to turn the train icons on so we can see where the trains are. Was that the train icon? No, it wasn't. That was the road icon. There we go, train icon. So we've got a couple here. I need to make sure that all the trains are pointing in the right direction and stuff. Now, we've only got three trains running on the stone. We've only got two trains running on the building materials line. So I'm pretty sure we're going to have to add another train to there, like, relatively soon. Now, the oil line. So this is Rogie Oil that runs down into the station from the opposite direction. Now, this one, I think we're going to have exactly the same issue with the station. Yeah, it's only a 240. We want to upgrade that to a 320. So we know for sure that we're going to get rid of... Now, I just want to show you this. See, this train, that's fine. He's coming out of the station. But look at these two trains. That one's okay. That should be coming down here. But this one has got flipped around. And that would break everything. So that needs to be flipped around, told to go the opposite direction. And it's just those three trains. So again, I think we're going to need to bump this up. I think we're going to need to quad track this at some point. So let's get rid of this. I mean, I don't know. Should I quad track it now? I mean, there is an argument for it. I don't know. We might do that. We might do that. I want to keep pushing it and improving it and expanding it and stuff. Now, let's push that back to there. Let's upgrade this. So we want, let's see, number of tracks. We'll go up to... we only need two stations. We'll go to 320 high-speed catenary, yes. I'm not going to have the extra street connections on this one, I don't think. Am I? No. Okay, upgrade that. Oops. Try pressing upgrade, bonehead. Why can't I apply that? Oh, now, you know what? I was actually looking at this before, and I know why that's doing it, and it took me a while to figure out. And it's because I put this furniture on here, and that's what's stopping this from upgrading. So be very careful if you start adding benches and stuff, because you won't be able to upgrade afterwards. So let's get rid of that and that and that. I should have mentioned at the beginning of the video that I've reset this, as I said I would, back to January the 10th, 2055, and we are going to be doing that a fair bit. Right, now I don't know if these fences are going to be in the way. Let's see. So, two platforms, 320. Yep, see? Yep, the fences are in the way. So we'll have to get rid of those babies on both sides. Try and avoid getting rid of the trees if I can. I'll try and avoid getting rid of too much of it if I can. Now, see? That fence there, I'm going to have to get rid of. Anything else causing a problem? Let's try now. Upgrade. Oh, and now it works. Hooray. So, two platforms, 320, high-speed catenary. Yes, apply. Cha-ching. Alrighty. And then hook it up to here at about the same level. There we go. So it looks nice and even. Cool. Awesome sauce. Oh, I like it. I like it. Then... all we need to do is run these into here, all the way down. And of course we get even bigger bridges than we had before. And I do love my big bridges. So bring you down, and then last one is this one. So bring you down to here. And of course it gives us more tracks, and more tracks is good news. This is transport fever after all. It's not building fever or tree fever. We want to see transport. We want to see loads of trains and all kinds of stuff. I might even try and get some boats going somewhere, somehow, at some point. God knows how. Let's bring that up to there. Let's level with that one. And then try and get them to join nice and evenly. Yeah, that's nice. Oh, if this will do the same thing, this will be really cool. And it will. See, it's really nice when you get like these little things nice and level and even, and the whole thing just looks so much better. Cool. Alright. Having done that, do a little bit of terrain smoothing around there. Now if we drop this down a little bit, there we go, we can get these pillars to actually look proper. So, yeah, there's going to be a lot of that kind of stuff going on offline. These trains are actually on the wrong one for what we want. So, now this train is coming down here. That's actually going to be fine. It's this one that's the problem. I could force that train onto this track. like this. So if I demolish, let's see, that bit of track and that bit of track. Right, now, you, where are you? I want you. Oh, you're not going to show me the blooming engine now, are you? Oh, thanks for that. Right, if I take out that section to force the train onto here and then push it forward up here. And now let's see. We want this train. Well, we actually, I was going to push it onto this line. But yeah, no, I'm still going to push it onto that line. Let's just do it in that way. I was thinking, yeah, well, I could let it pull forward and then pull up onto this track and then go back onto that one, but that's way too complicated. So let's bring you down here and just try and get you to hook onto this, which it probably won't, but we'll see. Oh my God, I think it will. Yep, it will. Hooray. Okay, so let's put you in. And then we demolish this track to push this train, force this train onto that track. There we go. Cool. And then we can put this bit of track in again. So that goes into there. Okay, so that's all fixed. Man, that took a little bit of fixing, didn't it? But now that'll work. So we've now sorted out the Rogie Oil, the Rogie Stone, and the Rogie CM. Do I want to do anything signals-wise here? And the answer is kind of, yeah, just a couple. Just a couple. So we want a signal probably just in front of where this train is, or like where that train is actually, there. So I put a signal train, a signal in there. So that train's going to pull out. That train should pull out behind it, and then that train should pull into the station, and everything should run. Okay, we do need a bit of signalling in the tunnel. And of course, with four tracks, it becomes a little bit difficult. So I'm going to put a signal there, and a signal there. Then go over to the other side and put a signal there, and signal there. Man, it's tricky. And then go and check that these are still running. Yeah, that's fine. So there, and we'll put one just outside the tunnel entrance. And there, and there. Now, do I want one kind of in between those two? Really, I should have put those a bit further back. Yeah, we'll put one more in. So there, and there, and come over to the other side, and there, and there. There we go. Cool. And then we're going to want some signals. I'm going to put in two lots because we might end up running quite a few trains on this. So signal there, boom, and boom, and then one more over here. There, there. And there, and there. Cool. Alright, so that is those three done. So we can now say, yeah, those are going to run smoothly. So let's close those down. Those are done. Alright, now, by the way, when I actually started this up, and I kind of started to do some stuff, and I had a crash. So I'm actually going to save the game, like, quite frequently. And you can see like all the saves that I've been doing recently. So I'm going to start save at this reset restart point. But we'll have restart point two, I think. There we go. And there's the save done. And it's just so that if I have another crash, which I think actually the crash was caused by my video recording software. But I'm not taking any chances. Anyway, right, that's that. Let's get over to Confuseford. Now, we've got a bit more work to do over at Confuseford. This is a bit more difficult because none of these lines are showing up. In fact, we can get rid of those completely now, I think. And we can close that down as well. So you can see none of these lines are showing up at all. And it's because I've got to put connections on here. We've got trains which are going in the wrong directions. So, for example, this should be coming up here, so that's flipped around. So it's all the same things that I've just done over on these trains. So, because you've already seen it once, I'm going to do this offline, and we'll come back to it. Okay, the oil, fuel, stone and construction materials are all done, and that took me a lot longer than I thought it was going to take, because I've ended up quad-tracking all of those four lines. So, but I got to say, it does look quite impressive now. So we've got this station, we've got these two are quad tracked. The brown is the construction materials. This is the fuel line going up here through the tunnel, over the bridge, and then into the construction materials goes into this one. The fuel obviously carries on. I've put loads of signals in on all of these lines, and then we've got the stone. Obviously, line takes over, and I had to like rechange the roads, and because I was trying to fit the extended stations. I've extended all of the stations to 320s now, and then played around with these tunnel entrances and all kinds of stuff. It's been a lot of fun, and putting signals in the tunnels, which is always a bit tricky, trying to get the signals next to each other in like on the right track and whatever when they're underground, very difficult. The fuel line comes into here, the stone line continues past and goes up into here, all quad tracked, and I've checked all of the trains and everything is hunky-dory. Now I had fun with this one. All right, let me show you. This is the oil, so the oil's getting shipped in from here over to here past Confusedford. And then it goes into the refinery, and then from the refinery it goes directly to the fuel line. But this line, when I decided to quad track this, what I hadn't thought about was if we follow this line up here, and they do look right really good now that they're quad tracked. I have to say it is kind of an improvement. But what I hadn't thought about was this bridge, because this bridge was not easy. I had so much messing around to get this in. In actual fact, you can see I haven't actually put this road back in because I just had a nightmare with trying to get the pillars in. And I got a sneaky suspicion that this road won't go at this angle if I try and put it back in. Let's see, this should be a large country road, shouldn't it? Will you go back in? No, see, it won't quite go back in. I wonder if I can get it to... Like, is there any way that'll go? I don't think that'll go through at that angle. No way. So, tell you what, what about the other way? If we go through, let's do it from the other side. Now, is there any kind of angle that we can get you? Now, if I come out, like, maybe a little bit further, like that, and then bring it through so it's coming through a little bit straighter. Oh, it'll do that. That it will do. But that's not a particularly nice angle. Oh, man. But you know what? We may just have to take that because the kind of isn't really an alternative. If we maybe bring this back a little bit and get it like as kind of straight as we can. Yeah, it's a bit strange, but we're gonna have to live with that. It all adds a little bit of character. So it's all the little imperfections and things that kind of add the character to the whole thing. Although there's actually a little bit too much character there for me, because when I look at this, it's like, yeah, no. Let's take that back to there. And then let's see, what do you do then? Does that look better? God, it's kind of frustrating because it was such a nice angle before. It was really, really good. We're gonna have to take it. I think we're gonna have to take it. I might come back and revisit that. I mean, I'm gonna be going round here like again and again, like for all kinds of things. Terrain smoothing and adding trees and adding more buildings and props and stuff around the place. So there's plenty of opportunities to get on with that. Anyway, Eventually, I got that bridge sorted out after a lot of playing around, and then this station was lower, and when I extended it, the angle from when it comes over this bridge to get down to the station was really sharp. So I ended up having to raise the terrain, and then I put this 320 station in. They're all 320s. But I put it raised up, so then I had to redo the roads and stuff. So yeah, a lot has been messed around with. It's all kind of basically the same, but loads and loads of messing around. And then I came to look at the Applejack line, and this is more complicated because, okay, fine, we'd have to upgrade that to a 320. Well, that's not too big a problem. We'd have to run, obviously, four tracks through here. But, yeah, you know, we could do it. We add a track on either side rather than adding two tracks on one side because I want to keep this balanced through here. And then it would be the same at this. You remember this junction? We could do the same through there, so that's not a problem. But this track is running on the wrong side, really, because we're coming up on the right hand side rather than going up on the we're coming down on the right hand side rather than going up on the right hand side. And the reason that we're doing that is because of the train station here. So this would need to be increased to a 320, but it would also need to be increased to like four platforms so that like all four platforms could go through. And then if I put the roads on both sides, then we could get it to actually be going up on the right hand side, because at the moment on the left hand side it doesn't stop at the station. So yeah, I mean, I could do that, but I think what we'll do, since we haven't got a food line over there, we'll leave that for now, so that we can kind of like get on and do some other things. So I guess I don't know. We'll have kind of a big go at all the food lines at some point. But we've opened up the potential for loads more capacity as these lines start to build up, and they've still got a lot of building up to do. I mean, you look at the quarry. Well, now the quarry's up. The quarry's at 1,000 now. That's more than I thought, actually. Let's see. You're at 1,200, so that's pretty damn good. That's at 1,200 as well. Awesome. Okay, things are rocking and running. What are you at? I looked at one, and it was only like 60 or something. Was it the oil up here? No, it couldn't be. Where are we? No, that's like 1,500. Yeah. I don't know which. I looked at one and it was like really low, but maybe I looked at the wrong thing. It's eminently possible. Okay, that's enough of that. Right, what are we going to do next? Oh, I know what we can do. How do you guys fancy sitting and watching for like 2 hours while I put in all of the signals on the Mega Halo, like 8 wide everywhere, like they are here? Would you like to see that? No? Really? Okay, good job I've already done it then. I mean, God knows how many signals I put in, but it's a lot. Like most of the time, I mean, by the stations, it's just like three at each end or four at each end, depending on whether the outer halo is going around. But in the rest of the place, where the halo joins up, it's like 8 signals in each. So I mean, if you call it 10, then yeah, it's hundreds of signals. Each one of these is 8 signals, so it's just, I literally put in, I don't know, it's got to be at least 1,000 signals that I put in. That was a bit of a job. Oh, I tell you what we can do, because I did some work on the terrain over here. Because you remember, we put in the one airport, but the other airport wouldn't go in, and I said I'd do it offline. So hopefully this should be at a point now where we can put the airport in. So, here we go. And I want it about there, I think. Is that quite level? It looks about level, doesn't it? But maybe round a bit like that. Yeah, okay, let's put that in there. And the reason that I wanted to get that put in now was so that between now and the next episode, I can work on the terrain and get all of that sorted out and all the rest of it, and then we can hopefully get the airport going in the next episode. Right, so what, oh man. Look at all this. So much to sort out. It's crazy. What are we going to do next then? Well, in each episode, what I want to do is address some specific problems, like getting the freight on here, like in this episode, and getting all the signalling done so that the passenger trains are going to work properly on the Halo. And then what I want to do is like run it and see what the impact of the changes that we've made is, and like watch it, you know, like watch the freight going and see how the production is, and do we need more trains and all the rest of it. And then I'll, between that episode and the next episode, I'll rewind it to January the 10th and then make changes based on what we saw. Just before we started up, there are two things that we need to fix. Okay, first thing, and I tell you what, this actually took a lot of spotting. I was looking at this train trying to figure out what the hell was wrong with it. Because this train's saying no path electric, and I was thinking, like, well, the catenaries are there and everything, and I played around with the track, and I couldn't figure out what the hell was wrong with it. And that, what was weird was the other trains are fine, they're all okay, right? And then I suddenly realized it's on the wrong line. This is the stone line, this is the grey stone line, and this is actually a CM train that somehow got stuck on here. So it's like, well, oh man, what do we do about that? Well, there's a couple of things that we can do potentially. I can either dump it into it, like just create a depot here and get it to go into the depot. Or we could get the train to be replaced. Now, which one? It's this one. How old is it? Oh, it's 22 years old. So what we could do is just replace it with a new train. Ew. Now, you know what? Let's have a look at the other two trains on here. Are they old trains as well? Detail. That's 22 years old. That's 22 years old. Ah, okay, fine. Well, this becomes an easy fix then. So we'll go over to here. This is the... let's go down here. This is the... this is TF, isn't it? Yeah, trains. TF, Rogie... not CM, Stone. There we go. Oh, now, but this one we need to change. So we'll say you are now going to be on the TF Rogie Stone Line. Cha-ching. Cool. So now we've got three vehicles on there. But this obviously needs to get changed. So replacement. Replace at 25%. Replace vehicles automatically. Set the vehicle first. So what are we going to have? We're going to have 185s. Yep, 185s with, now for this, we want the, got to get the right one. We need open wagons. Right, now, how many of these do we want? Well, we can go up to 320, can't we? Yes, we can. So let's do it. Let's go 290, 304, 318. Right, like, why wouldn't we go up to the max? Absolutely no reason. Look at that, 30 million for one. 30 million for one train. My God, I have to play in the American series. That's like shocking. 30 million for a train, my God. Okay, so. So auto-replace, yes, that's that. So that puts a third train on the stone line. Because, yeah, we only had two trains on the stone line. So now we've got three. But that means... that really we need to put another couple of trains, I think, on the building materials, because we've only got two on this line. So yeah, let's get a couple more trains on there. Now, but actually, before we do it, let's have a look at the setup for these trains. So first of all, let's have a look at the vehicles. So it's the Shy train and train 107. And let's see, how many we got? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. We're getting 12 cars. If we went replacement... I need to look how old they are first, don't I? Yeah, so let's have a look. Yeah, 22. So, no problem. We'll get them replaced. They're over 50% of their life anyway, so not a bad idea to replace them. So we'll go again with 185. And then we want state cars up to 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. See, 12 is only 235. So let's go up to, oh, that's one too many. So we'll go up to 307, replace 25%, yes. All right, cool. So that will replace the two that we've got on there, but we want an extra two put onto that line. So let's create a depot down here, I think, and we'll feed them on going up to the building materials. So down here, I think. Let's put in, depot. Where are we? Depot. Flip you around. Pop you in there. There's going to be so much tinkering to get all this to work. Right, so you go in there. That should have been high speed tracks. So what do I want? High speed tracks. Let's convert those to high speed tracks. Thank you. Happens every time you reload the game. It resets everything. I wish it'd remember like what your settings were when you saved the game. Right, so that's all looking good. So now we can buy an extra couple of trains. So what do we want? 185 with state cars up to 307 in length. Boom, boom, there we go. Two of those, please. Set the line. And this is TF Rogie CM. Boom. All right, cool. Excellent. Okay, so that has fixed the two problems that that I knew about. Everything else, I've fixed. Like trains that were flipped around and all that kind of stuff and whatever. So yeah, we are ready to kick it off now. This is the bit I like the best. Right, let's go. Crank. Okay, so should we watch the new trains come out first, I suppose? Here we go. Now, because I've just turned it on, like with so many changes and stuff, I do expect a little bit of lag, but hopefully it'll kind of even itself out a little bit once it kind of figures what's going on. Let's turn the red stuff off. I might turn the green stuff off as well. Yeah, let's do that as well. Alrighty, here comes the next one. Good. Alrighty, so that worked. Now, did that train upgrade? Yes, I think it did. Train 105. I think that was the one. Now, what I want to look at with this is whether three trains is too much on here and whether the incoming train has to wait. And, yeah, I've obviously got to upgrade this line now to having trains that are 320 because yeah, it's actually too long. The train can't actually turn round. Oh man. Okay, let me fix that and we'll restart it. Okay, reset, take two. This is now extended out to a 320 station, so the train should be able to turn round. Okay, so we go back over here, we'll be able to see those trains come out again. Oh, this is fun. Right, what am I doing? Right, go. So, there we go. There's the trains coming out. Right, so you are going to go into here. You're going to upgrade, hopefully. Cha-ching. And now it can turn around and go merrily on its way. And look at this. Already churning out the building. Man, the lag when it starts up is not good. Let's turn those off. There we go. That's a bit better. So, you're going to go up here. And drops off, turns around. Okay, here's the next train going up. So you're waiting on that train. Which is fair enough, because these have got to space out a bit. So what we wanted to see is whether these three trains can run on here. Yeah, Landsberg Heights, yeah, we know about that. What we want to see is these three trains, whether they can run without stopping. So here comes the next train and just has to stop for a few seconds and then it can pull in. Yeah, I think probably this needs to be quad tracked and just have two trains on each track is going to be the most efficient. See, that has to stop for a few seconds. That one goes out. We'll see. I mean, it does take time for them to space out. So you go. We should see with the next one coming down whether that has to wait, because now they've spaced out. And I'm thinking it is going to have to wait. Here it comes, because this is filling up. And especially when, because this is only half full. Yeah, it's having to wait. When that's got to fully load up, yeah. So it'll just be two trains ultimately, two trains on each line. But we'll quad track this. Okay, this all seems to be running pretty nicely. How are we doing? How's production up here? It's fallen a fair amount, but here we come with some more stone. Oh, yeah, we're keeping it up at around 700, and hopefully that should start to go up a bit now. And we're getting the building materials, and they're getting shipped down. Let's go down and have a look down here. Oh, yes, we've got building materials, we've got fuel. How's the production over here? It's going up, it's going up. Here comes the next fuel train. And the next fuel train rolls in with 225 fuel. 5 million. Oh, loads. Loads of stuff. The Sector 1 Halo trains are loading up. He's not getting any food, but then he wouldn't. But he's just loaded up with a full load of oil, of fuel. You're coming in to pick up building materials. And yeah, full load. Off you go. Oh, that passenger trains are whizzing through. They're all running nicely. Oh, guys, I think it's all going quite well. How are you doing? You got passengers on board? Yeah, 55. They will all have been empty because we've knocked down virtually every passenger station, so it doesn't surprise me that those trains aren't running full at the moment. What about you? Yeah, 54. They'll be running full soon enough. This is coming in. This is a slightly bigger train. 300. Picks up a full load. Shall we? We've got autosave end of year. Now, you know what? Let's have a little ride on this train, because we've never had it. Did we have it? I suppose we kind of had it working before, where it's picking up at both ends. Yeah, we kind of did. So you drop off, you make a million there, and you're going to whiz on to the next station and make more money there. Oh, passenger train speeding past. Come on, stop being laggy, damn you. Oh, we've got an oil train speeding the other way. Now, pause for a second. How much oil are you carrying? Oh, you've only got 16... Sorry, how much fuel left? You've only got carrying 16 fuel down there. Let's let them carry on. Let's go up to the other end and check out these lines. So over here, oh yeah, we've got food, we've got fuel, we've got building materials, and we've got freaking millions of trains coming in. So you're filling up with food, excellent. And let's look over here. Is all of this looks like it's working? That's a fuel train. Here comes a building materials train, carrying 120, almost full. Peachy. Here comes an Applejack train. The Applejack cart number two. He's bringing in just 91 food. So that's taking time to get up to speed again. Again, not a surprise. There's a local train. That's on the mini Halo. Only 31 passengers at the moment. We've got another oil train coming in to fill up. Another mini Halo train going by. Oh my god, this is so good! This is so good! Oh, which train are you? Oh, you've just filled up. Oh, freaking Awesome. Let's go and have a look at the production numbers. So, we're definitely going to have to boost up the old Applejack line. So you're coming in and picking up livestock. What's the production over here? Oh, 1,500. Whoa, full load. Awesome. So that should mean that this thing should be running at about the same level. Yeah, 1,400 and going up. So that's getting right back up to speed. So let's have a look at the last train that pulled out. How much are you carrying? 100 of a possible 169. So almost a full load. Not quite, but almost a full load. Now remember, when we get the other sector set up, this will be split between the two sectors. All right, so we won't be shipping as much. So this is why we need to quad track, because running at even like running at maximum capacity and maybe putting an extra train on here and there or whatever, it's not going to be enough to fully supply all the cities when we've got like all the sectors running. But oh my god, this is freaking beautiful when it's all running, isn't it? You know what? Let's turn off all of that. Let's turn off that. So we've just got the names so that we can just enjoy the trains running around. And adding trains onto these lines and whatever, like for example here, I'll probably stick a bunch of depots on this end, just a line of depots so that we can get trains put on there. Probably do that. If I wanted to, I could set up like a whole rail yard with loads of depots and all the rest of it, and then I don't know, tunnel this road or something. Oh, I need to do so much work on this. I need to do to this kind of like what I did with where's the old Maesli? Did I rip out the old Maesli? No, I didn't. I left it over here. It's over here. We need to do this kind of thing with it, where you know we put in all the little shrubs and we put in some extra buildings and some roads around, and but even that isn't good enough. It needs to be a combination of like this. And if we go down here, this kind of stuff. See, this, I don't know about you, I think this looks really good. This looks like a proper production facility. With all the extra oil tanks all over the place and the extra buildings. I shouldn't be surprised at the lag. I'm running it on 3x speed. If you actually run it on normal speed, yeah, I can see my frame rate jumps up. And now it's not so laggy. This is just beautiful. Just beautiful. And that's taking out another full load of construction materials. How many passengers you got? Still 57. Let's have a quick look at the old line profitability and see. So, Halo. The inner Halo, anti-clockwise, is doing great. But that's got 10 trains on. This has only got 6. So that's something else that I've got to do, is put extra trains on to balance those out. Halo Trans 1's got like 21 trains, whereas Halo Trans 2 has only got like 13. So there's a lot to be done still. God, like so much to be done. But these numbers are starting to pick up, so hopefully these are going to start making some money soon. Halo Sector 1 oil is already making 63 million, which is awesome. Sector 1 construction materials making 30 million. Oh, here we go. Halo Trans 2 has just started to turn a profit. Halo Trans 1 is not too far behind. Yeah, so I think we have made a major step in the right direction. And now that we're back and running, and I've kind of got my plan worked out for how I'm going to do this now, you should be expecting to see episodes more frequently now. For this and the American series, I want to get episodes out at least every other day. So you'll have either an American or a European. But I'm going to try and get out like two episodes a day some days. It kind of depends how much time I have to spend. And I tell you what, I mean, just looking at this, right? That needs to curve more, you know. That straight bit just doesn't look right, does it? That just looks wrong. That needs to curve properly across there. And these are little things that we're going to be doing. And the fact that it dips there is wrong. That should be a smooth flowing curve, and it needs to be at a consistent height as well. So let's see, how are you doing? Oh, you're up to 129 passengers on the outer halo. So that's going well. Let's have another look at the line probability. So where were we? Clockwise is making a profit now. Anti-clockwise is still a little bit behind. CM's up to 40 million. Oil's up to 70 million. This is up to 15 million now. That was losing 15. Now it's only losing 10. So that's catching up as well. Let's have a look at the mini halo, because the mini halo was losing money. Like, even when it was running properly, it was losing money. Where's the mini halo? TF. Oh, here we go. Oh, TP. TP mini halo. Oh, we're making money, guys. We're making money on the mini halo. This one's making 15 million now. This one's just making a tiny loss. But it's the passenger numbers are definitely increasing. So that's really good as well. Okay, I mean, we've got to get the TGV running. I think the next episode, we work on the TGV, get the TGV hooked up. I did start on it when I was working on this. If I just bring this up, I took the tunnel back to here, but it actually needs to go back even further to get like a really nice straight run into here, because that's going to be like a fair bend. We don't want that. We want that to be nice and straight. We've still got to do the airport and all that kind of stuff. Man, so much to do. And when I reloaded, I lost the airport. Duh! So I'll put the airport back in quickly. Let's just quickly throw that back in. There we go. And I tipped it around like one little one, didn't I? There we go. So, oh, come on. Zoom in a little bit. Going nice and straight there. Cha-ching. 13.5 million. All right, cool. By the way, I often get asked every now and then, why are you using two airports? Because I want to. Seriously. And hopefully that's all going to work out. I can't wait to get the airports flying. The planes are just so beautiful in this. And I want to have a little look around here and I see the trains starting to run around this dogging section. Because it is very, very cool. How are you doing? The thing is, a lot of these cities aren't even connected. I mean, that one is, but we've already been getting the messages about like Landsberg Heights isn't connected. That's Winniston. Landsberg Heights. I mean, yeah, this thing isn't connected, even connected to the roads. Some of these are like barely connected. They don't have the proper transport infrastructure. So, yeah, if we want to get our Halo passenger trains back up to the profits that they were making before we put the big change in, then, yeah, still a huge amount of work to do. But, man, isn't it rewarding? This is what I love about this, that if you put the effort in, you're really rewarded with what you get back. And, I want to work on, like, the riverfronts and stuff so that you get stuff like this. You actually get nice riverfronts with the properties, like, right up against. I mean, look at this. This is really, really sweet. And you look over here. This is, I guess, look, this is obviously a commercial district over here because of these types of very big, flashy buildings. So, look. Are you commercial? Oh, actually, it's mixed. That surprises me. So these are commercial. These are residential. Wow. And again, you know, we can start to look at some of these places. Now, oh, that's right. Wasn't I? Oh, yeah. I was trying to split this, wasn't I? And get all of the residential on this side. This is the thing. You need to be, like, right on top of it when it starts growing back. If you want to keep it split, you've got to stay on top of the buildings and, like, knock them down as they grow to try and get that split. Because I was trying to have the residential over here and have all of the commercial industrial over there, wasn't I? I think that's what I was trying to do. Oh, man. Wow. Okay, well, you know what, guys? We'll leave it there for this episode. A really, really good step forward, but I think it just goes to show you how much there is to do. And I've spent, how long have I spent on this one? I spent about 7 hours on this. Seven to eight hours, right, to just get that done. It's amazing how you get sidetracked. Like, as well as doing all the things that I've told you that I've done, I get sidetracked onto, like, little bits, and I'll be smoothing the terrain and just reworking a road and, like, putting a few more trees in and stuff like that. And you end up spending, like, a fair old amount of time just tinkering with little bits and pieces. But that's the fun. That's what I love doing, so I'm certainly not going to complain about it. And it just gets better and better and better looking. I'm looking at that hill now and thinking, man, that really needs some trees on top to kind of blend it into the terrain. And it's going to look so much better. And then you get into it and you look at it and you think, yeah, you know what? That hill is just a little bit too high. It just needs to be smoothed out. And I don't like the look of this. This needs to be kind of like more abrupt across here rather than this kind of big bowl. So many things to do. All right, guys. Leave me your comments. Let me know what you think. I'll catch you for the next one. Peace out.